your boy, West Bread Diamond.
And I'm Crappie Killer.
This episode is something that honestly will strike everybody as crazy.
Experience of a lifetime. Never will forget it. I can't wait. Let's go into this episode.
We is about to fish for sturgeon in a motherfucking kayak.
So when this one right here say, come on, bro, we got to get this kayak shit done, and we out here fishing for sturgeon, I'm not going to lie. I was scared like a motherfucker.
Sturgeon General out here today, and he's going to teach us how to kayak
now,
fish.
Now, Sturgeon General is somebody that actually reached out to us. He's been a fan since the beginning episodes. He always was in our inbox like, hey, you guys, get out here with me and try. I got enough kayaks for everybody. You guys can come out here and we can experience it together. Before, he was like, I already got my name. He was like, my name is Sturgeon General.
The Sturgeon General is out here smooth in the motherfucker. He yakking with a motherfucking bro.
Because he was doing stuff that we would never do.
We seen him flip the kayak just out there in the water, flip it. Come back
he
up
dove
over water.
Off like, the kayak and jumped onto a log while we were out there fishing.
Y'all look like the Swedish ski team.
Those names start coming out of everywhere because if you seen that outfit, soon as he put it
what
on.
What you call me?
I'm serious. You look like a black NASCAR driver.
The NASCAR driver.
I felt like a NASCAR driver.
It was just because it's like, okay, we getting on these kayaks, and he was like, yeah, I got a couple of suits for you guys. I was, as soon as they said suits, I was like, them two right there.
Jamaica's got a bobsled team.
Big ass bumblebee. I said, what else did I say? You look like a sleeping
bobsled
bag.
Team.
The Jamaican bobsled team.
No, you look like one of Michael Jackson dancers. Did you panic? Don't lie, Crappy. Did you panic?
A little bit.
I was scared. He was terrified.
Soon as we got to that open water, that's what just it just hit me.
Fuck the kayak.
He was.
I start swallowing my spit. I start having anxiety like a motherfucker. I'm looking at them.
He wasn't tired.
The boat was close.
Scared.
Give me the boat.
I'm about to hand this motherfucker to you.
People never seen me really on it is because I'm usually the person behind the camera.
No, he
never
was
made
on
the cut. It never made the cut, but
you were in it though.
On the episode, it's not.
You sure?
Bro, I promise you.
We're gonna find it.
What was crazy about this episode was it was some people that was right there that actually worked those docks.
Uh-oh, here come the police.
He pulled up on us at first. I actually kind of edited a lot of it out because he was being very rude.
Oh, yeah.
He was being very rude. He said, yeah, you guys, no one's allowed to fish over here. The guy that we were with, he said, I'm here every day on my kayaks. What do you mean nobody's allowed to fish here?
Never had this happen.
He was like, well, yeah, we haven't said anything to you guys before, but it's starting to become a problem now. And Mike was like, he was like, I think it's just the problem is, you know, we have these guys with us. And he actually confronted them.
They done called the police on the kayak.
The guy went, reported us to the Coast Guard.
Coast Guard ended up being our
Coast
fans.
Guard, I knew it when he was pulling up because after when he first started seeing the cameras, he started doing this. Then he pulled up on us and he was like, yeah, you guys, they wanted me to kind of get you guys out of here, but you're not doing nothing. We see what you are doing, you know, and we love your fishing show.
Yeah, you guys are funny. I like being here.
Thanks, man. Thanks, man. Greatly appreciated. Today, you have seen justice.
When they left, the guy, the same guy that pushed up on us the first time, he seen that the Coast Guard didn't do anything to us, and right after the Coast Guard left, and then they opened it up.
Oh, shit, look, they got y'all. Look how they did us, y'all.
Now, when they open this thing up, it is hundreds of tons of water.
We in a whirlpool.
Then the second one came, then the third one came.
Ah, they tried to kill us! They tried to hit Deshaun ass with the water. They tried to put him in the water, you guys.
They did it to us three different occasions. And even though we were all joking and we made fun of it and everything else, at the end of the day, we all were discussing that. Like,
never happens when I fish with my white friends.
And he was saying it in a joke, but it was actually some crazy stuff that was happening right there.
It was trying to kill us.
We made fun about it, but we could have actually died in this episode.
We made it.
We made it.
I don't know why they chose today of all day to flush the toilets right on us.
I don't know.
The Dino Hunter said, that guy said, I've been fishing 12 years, ain't never met a warden or Coast Guard, but today met half the fleet, laughing my fucking ass off, priceless. We
it's
laughed
like
about it and we
time.
Made it a funny episode, but a lot of people were able to see, like,
we
you
go
know
through
what I'm
this
saying?
All the time on the river. We used to it. We see the fleets, we see the game warden, we see everybody, we see the state, we see the law. We used to it. They know us now. They just want to get on camera.
And even though Mike was saying it as a joke, he was serious.
Pretty sure we're going to meet half the Coast Guard fleet by noon.
Paul G. Big ass fish taking you for a sleigh ride.
Chia doggy.
You know what? Just think about it. You on a kayak fishing for a fish bigger than the damn kayak.
Think about it.
Sleigh ride is something fun. You got to go for that sturgeon ride on that yak. You guys got to see. Then you're going to see your own face get like mine.
Now, what's this dude's name? I'm going to be honest with you. You Huntler 421. Oh shit, this is so great. Even the Coast Guard was laughing too. The Coast Guard was laughing too because it's like, it's infectious, man. What we do is infectious.
He was a real fan,
and that was honestly, that's what it's about, man. It's about us bridging these gaps. Honestly, that's the whole purpose of what this show is.
He was there to protect us, actually. He knew what was about to happen.
He knew they was gonna try to drown us.
Yeah, you guys are funny.
Thank you again for tuning in to episode 8. Continue to tune in. You can only find this exclusively on
CarbonTV.com.